Pundari Puravasine Panduranga Prakashaya Vithalaya Namo Namaha Marutputraya Kavaye Bhimaya Bhayaharine Srimadananda Tirthaya Prakhyataya Namo Namaha Shivatanaya Varishtam Sarvakalyana Murtim Parashukamarahastam Shobitam Mudakena Arunakusumamala Vyalalam Bodaram Tam Maharadaya Nivasam Shri Ganesham Namami Krishna Prata Krishna Manusmaranta Ratrauja Krishna Punaruttitai Te Krishna Deha Pravishanti Krishna Ajyam Yatha Mantra Hutam Hutashi Ramaya Rama Bhadraya Ramachandraya Vedase Raghunathaya Nathaya Sitaya Pataye Namaha Buddhirbalam Yashodhiryam Nirbhayatvam Arogatam Ajadhyam Vakvadutvam Chal Hanumasmaranam Bhavet Chitrai Padaischa Gambhirai Vakyamanai Rakhanditai Guruhavam Vyanjayanti Bhati Shri Jayatirthavat Pranamatkamadhenuncha Bhajatsuratarupam Shri Bhavabhoda Krippada Chintamani Mupasmahe Pujyaya Raghavendraya Satyadharvarataya cha Bhajatam Kalpavrikshaya Namatam Kamadhenave Annapurne Sadapurne Shankara Pranavallabhe Jnana Vairagya Siddhyartham Vikshyam Dehi cha Parvati Hayagriva Hayagriva Hayagriviti Yode Tasya Nisrate Vani Jannu Kanya Pravahavate Raka Chandra Samana Kanti Vadaram Naka Dhiraja Suta Muka Nama Pikurvati Surabhuni Parampara Pashupati Akarani Rajate Satyam Vidhatum Jalutya Vashitam Vyaptim Chalute Shvakileshu Japmana Adrushyata Atyat Mutarupam Udvaham Tam Bhesamayam Namrgam Namanusham Narasim Namrgam Namanusham
die for Sri Rama. One is Dasharatha and the other is Jatayu. Give them a big hand. Only three people give up their lives. Dasharatha. The moment he finds that Rama is leaving for the forest, his prana is also leaving. I can't live without my son. Vibrato hi Ramena muhurtam avinoksahe. I can't live without Rama. You take me, you take my battalion, you take my army, you take anybody, but don't take Rama. My master Dikshita wanted to make the situation humorous, so he would say that Vasishtha went close to Dasharatha and whispered something in his ear. What did he whisper? You want daughters-in-law? Four daughters-in-law? Send him, send him. Send Rama with the great one called Vishwamitra. And Vishwamitra is now taking Sri Rama and Lakshmana into the forest. As they are going, Vishwamitro yayo vagre kato ramo mahayasha kaka pakshadharo dhanvi tamcha saumitri mandarama. First Vishwamitra, then Sri Rama and then Lakshmana. All three of them go into the forest, and in the forest, here is the mantra given to Sri Rama. Rama doesn't need mantra. Rama mantra itself is enough to save us. Rama doesn't need mantra.
It is only to tell us that the Guru has to give us mantra. What is mantra? Etymological meaning of mantra is Mananat Trayate Iti Mantraha. That which protects you. When you do manana, when you meditate on that mantra, it protects you. And whenever we are doing any sadhana, we are likely to become tired, we are likely to have fatigue, we are feeling sleepy, we are likely to have temperature. All this happens when you start some sadhana. But if you have a mantra, that mantra will protect you. Nakshramam najvaruvate narupasya vipargayaha. Any sadhana you start, you will have a badha. In order to get over the badha, you need a mantra. This mantra I am giving to you, Sri Rama. Mananat Trayate Iti Mantraha. The Bala and Atibala mantra are given to Sri Rama and Lakshmana so that they will conquer sleep and fatigue, and when they are sleeping, the demons and the demoness cannot attack them. And Sri Rama is lying on the ground. For your information, in sleep and in death, the true nature of the human being is evident. Is that clear? In sleep and in death, the true swabhava of the individual is evident in the face. Sri Rama is lying on the ground, on the grass, and Valmiki describes Vishwamitra's reaction. He is a dry intellectual. He is not a bhakta. But when he sees Vishnu's form in the face of Sri Rama, he says, oh, this is the beautiful drishya that Kausalya sees every day. I am jealous of that woman. I am jealous of that woman called Kausalya who wakes up the Lord every day. Today I have the opportunity of waking up the Lord, of saying the Suprabhatam, and how lucky she must be to be waking up the Lord every day. Kausalya Supraja Rama Purva Sandhya Pravartate Uttishtha Narashardula Kartavyam Daivamanhikam Kartavyam Daivamanhikam. That is what our Bhattacharya say early in the morning at 3 o'clock to Venkateswara. Kausalya Supraja Rama Purva Sandhya Pravartate Uttishtha Narashardula Kartavyam Daivamanhikam Uttishtha Uttishtha Govinda Uttishtha Garuda Dhvaja Uttishtha Kamala Kanda Trailokyam Mangalam Guru. Wake up, my Lord, wake up. You have to do your duty. If you don't do your duty, everybody will be sleeping. But many of us, sleep is an occupation. You ask people, what are you doing on Sunday? Sleeping. I call it Kumbhakarna Gotra. How long can you sleep? If you're tired, I can understand. You had a surgery, I can understand. You had a baby, I can understand. But not healthy people sleeping. Time is passing. I'm preoccupied with this concept of sleep. And I tell people, wake up. Because sleep is the daily rehearsal of the eternal drama of death. I hope you like the definition. Sleep is the daily rehearsal of the eternal drama of death. There's an eternal drama called death. And every day in sleep we are rehearsing this drama. We are only rehearsing this drama. One day we will not wake up. Before that, get up. All our great temples open early in the morning. I'm very happy that even children at 1:30 have a bath and go to the Suprabhatam. You cannot sleep in Tirumala in the morning, even if you want to. Because the wake-up call is there. Something is waking you up, waking up the soul. You're not waking up the body, you're waking up the soul. The Lord does not need Suprabhatam. Suprabhatam is for us, for you and me. So that we wake up to Dharma, we wake up to do our duty. Get up, Rama, get up. Because you have to do your duty. Kausalya Supraja Rama Purva Sandhya Pravartate Uttishtha. Please stand up. Get up. Why? Because you are Narashardula. You are the best among men. Kartavyam Daiva Manikam. The Hindu philosophy says all of us have to do whatever we have to do, whatever has been assigned to us. Whenever I talk about duty, I tell my audience, The sun rises, the moon rises, the winds blow, the rivers flow. It's only man on Monday morning who says, 1 week to go. Only man. Ayyo, 1 more week to go. There's no difference between Sunday and Monday. It's all in the mind. We have to do our duty. We have to do our duty. Duty is the beautiful burden that the Lord has given to us. And He Himself did His duty. In the Gita, the Lord says, yat yat acharati shreshtaha. I have to set a role model. Get up, Rama, get up. You have to set a role model for the world to follow, because you are the model for the world. Kausalya supraja Rama, purva sandhya pravartate, uttishtha nara shardula kartavyam daivamannikam. The Lord has to protect the yajna from a woman called Tataka. Tataka is a rakshasi who has the strength of 1,000 elephants. You can imagine, so much of strength she had. And the Lord kills her so that He can establish justice in the world. Tam apatattim vegena vikrantam vikrantam ashadimiva sharena ulasi vidyada sapapata mamaracha. He shot an arrow into her heart and she fell down. And when she fell down, the gods in heaven rained flowers, because Tataka, in one terrible element, bad element of the world, has been got rid of. As the children are moving along with Vishwamitra, whenever young children go along with the elders tell them about so many instances, so many episodes, so many histories are narrated. As Sri Rama and Lakshmana are walking along with Vishwamitraji, Vishwamitraji gives them several lovely episodes, and one of them is the Uma Vrittanta. All of us know Kapileshwara, Lord Shiva, is a master of Vairagya. He doesn't live for himself. He will wear snakes and give you gold. He will wear tiger skin and give you Pitambara. He will take the Nandigeshwara and give you the latest car. He will live in the crematorium and give you the beautiful palaces. You cannot win him with physical charm. You cannot win him with bhoga. You can only win him with yoga. And Mother Uma performs the tapas, panchagni tapasya. Kalidasa, in his inimitable way, describes in the Kumara Sambhava that Mother Uma performed the tapasya, and finally the Lord came as a brahmachari to test her. And when He came there, she didn't recognize Him. He asked her, "What are you doing tapasya for? To marry Lord Shiva? That Bairagi, that rustic fellow, that crude fellow who sits in the crematorium, why do you want to marry such a fellow? He doesn't even have a bank balance. He has only ashes that cover him and a tiger skin. When you get married, your silken sari will be tied to this tiger skin, and when the priest ties the knot, it will be a very, very unequal combination. You are not made for each other. And then the whole world will watch. When he embraces you, you will have chandanam on your heart and he will have ashes from the dead. What a combination is this? No, woman, no. Please give up. Please give up." She gets angry and says, "Get away if you are abusing my Lord Shiva." Suddenly my master, Lord Shiva, Nagendra Haraya, Trilushanaya, Basmangaragaya, Maheshwaraya, is standing there and holding her hand. She feels shy because she's praised the Lord so much, not knowing it's the Lord Himself. And the Kumar Sambhava says, "Mother Uma, Mother Parvati, had 1 foot raised and 1 foot on the ground." What a lovely video of Kalidasa. This beautiful woman who is the daughter, Shailadi Rajatanaya Nayayo Natastho, says Kalidasa. Neither did she go, nor did she leave. She's giving her hand to Lord Shiva and standing amazed at his appearance. This is how the great Kartikeya Swami came into the world. There are so many episodes which are eye-openers in the Ramayana, and one such is the episode of Sagaraputra. My dear audience, all of us know good deeds lead to good results, bad deeds lead to bad results. There was a great Dharmatma called Sagara who had two wives, one was Sumati, one was Keshini. When he performed penance, He came to know that children will be born to both these women. And one of the sons who was born to Keshini was known as Asamanjas. Asamanja was one who performed feats of absolute stupid intentions. He was known for his indiscretion. He would take babies and throw them into the water, live babies to die in the water. He loved such sadism. The other brother, the other lady got several sons, and they were the ones who caused havoc in the family. One day a sacrificial horse was missing, and when the father said, go and search for them, they went into the Netherlands, and there they found Kapila Muni doing meditation. The horse was close by grazing. They thought he was the thief of the horse, and they blamed him. He looked at them with his tapasya, and they were turned to ashes. Nothing could redeem them. All of them were dead. The whole family tried, generation after generation, to bring back these Sagarapitras to a better state in their astral form, but nobody could do it until the right person came, and his name was Bhagiratha. Bhagiratha performed penance, stood on one foot, and it is he who brought Mother Ganges from the heavens. All of us know Ganga. Ganga is not a geographical concept for me. She is the culture and spirituality of India, perennially flowing down from the Himalayas, my dear listeners. I stood in Uttarkashi, watching the gorgeous flow of Ganga. My dear viewers, please remember that the Ganga is the perennial philosophy of India, flowing eternally from the Himalayas. I tell all parents, please take your children at least once a year, either to Tirumala, or to Haridwar, or to Vrindavan. Take them to Switzerland and Disneyland, wherever you want after that. But give them the samskaras. Give them the feel of India. This is India. 5-star hotels are not India. India is Ganga. India is Tirumala. India is Vrindavan. India is Chardham. India is that perennial philosophy come alive. Please remember that our children have to charge their body with the basics of India. Mother Ganga is the only one who is capable of purifying the thousands of children of Sagara who are dead. Bhagiratha is walking in front. I can almost see the video of Valmiki. Prayat agri mahatejan Ganga tam chapyanuvrajat. Bhagiratha is going. And how did he find the Ganga? Who can bear the Ganga when the Ganga falls from the heavens above? Ordinary Niagara Falls, you're scared to watch. It is so huge. Imagine Ganga falling. Who can bear? Only Lord Shiva. Only Lord Shiva. Shirasa dharayishyami shaira raja sutamaham tato hemavati haimavati jeshta sarva loka namaskrita tadasa sumhatrutam dutva vegam jagustaham akashat apatat ganga shive shiva shirasyuta achintayachasa devi ganga paramadurkara jagamandala Kapileshwara is the first seat of Mother Ganga. She falls to the heavens. Only he can bear it. Nobody else can bear it because of his tapasya. And then she falls on the ground. And slowly she is flowing. Bhagiratha is looking back. Follow me, follow me. That is how she comes to be known as Bhagirathi. That is how Bhagiratha is followed by Ganga, and she is known as Bhagirathi. She gives back those souls their regeneration, and they are established in the world of the astrals, in the world of the names. All of us know that Sagara's family has now been absolved of the sin that they had committed. Episode after episode in the Balakanda proves to Sri Rama what is dharma, and he is listening like a patient student. He is listening to whatever Vishwamitra has to say. Forgive me for my candor. I have to tell you what the Ramayana says about Ahalya. It's a warning to young ladies. Please be careful. This body has been given by the Lord. It has to be pure and protected. We cannot abuse this body as we like it. All of us know, although it sounds orthodox, although it sounds very old-fashioned, but this body is to be given only to the man we marry. You cannot afford to live as you like. Freedom does not mean license. And if freedom has been abused, we have to suffer for it. My dear girls, protect your purity. This is what the Ramayana says. The moment you are pure, you can look at anybody in the world in the face. The moment we fall, the world is accusing us. A very strange world it is. Never have we called a man a fallen man. We always said a fallen woman. It's a male-dominated society. Have you ever heard of the phrase a fallen man? No. It's a fallen woman. Everybody says it's a fallen woman. There are some women in the world, excuse me for saying it, but there are several women in the world who'd rather have a sensational affair with a celebrity. For a few hours of sensuous joy, they have sacrificed their chastity and lost purity forever. They will repent all their life, but there is no way except Sri Rama's grace. There was a saint called Gautama and his wife is Ahalya. They lived in a beautiful surrounding. Sri Rama walks into the ashram of Gautama and asks like an ignorant person, whose ashram is this, Swami? Vishwamitra says, this belongs to Gautama. He has a beautiful wife called Ahalya and they lived happily. They had a lovely garden. The garden was so lovely that even gods from heaven came for a picnic. And on one of those days, Indra came to have a nice time in the lovely garden. That day, his eye fell on the beautiful woman called Ahalya. Ahalya knew it was not Gautama. Indra came in the disguise of Gautama and she knew it was not Gautama. Please don't have any misunderstanding about the episode. Although she saw him and knew who it was, Munivesham Sahasraksham Vignaya Raghunandana Matim Chakara Suddur Medha Devaraja Kutuhalat